Alright, guys, I am back here to do a pick a card reading. Choices are reading 1, 2, and 3. Again, choices are reading 1, 2, and 3. The question is, there's no communication. What the hell is going on? One more time, there is no communication. What the hell is going on? And your choices are reading 1, 2, and 3. This is a general reading, guys. Roles may be reversed, may not resonate with everyone. Take what fits, release the rest. Only take what resonates, release the rest. I don't need to hear what doesn't resonate. I'm sorry that it doesn't resonate, but this is a general reading. I cannot tap into everyone's energy. But for those who this message will be for, please like, share, comment, and subscribe to the channel. Please, please, please. Thank you all. There have been so many of you who have subscribed to the channel or who have liked these readings, and I appreciate you all. So let's take a deep breath. Pick your reading, 1, 2, or 3, and let's get started. First reading up is going to be reading number 1. Reading number 1. So I travel for a living, guys, and I finally made it back home. I am no longer in the desert, which is where I've been for the past 3 weeks, and I'm very happy about that. Okay, let's go ahead and get started with reading number 1. There is no communication for those who chose reading number 1. What the hell is going on, universe? There is no communication for reading number 1. What the hell is going on? What's going on with those who have chosen read number 1? What the hell is going on? First card, Ace of Cups. Bon chicka wow wow. It's no communication. Second card. Got that Queen of Cups. Queen of Cups. And there is no communication for those who have chose reading number 1. What the hell is going on? And Six of Swords. Alrighty. Let's get Oracle card. There's no communication for the people who have chosen reading number 1. What the hell is going on? Love yourself first. Oof. I love it. One more. Express your love. All right, guys, so if you have chosen reading number 1, what I have for you is that this person right now is holding back, right? They're holding back their feelings. They're holding back their love. You see on this side, the Queen of Cups is holding that big ass cup. You see that big ass cup in the middle of it? Right. Okay. So she's holding that big ass cup, but on facing this direction or with her back to us, she doesn't want to let you in on how she feels. I say she just because it's the Queen of Cups. It's just divine feminine energy. So this can be a man or a woman. Doesn't matter. Take it how it resonates. But what she is wanting is this fountain, this newness, this beginning. You see all of these lotus flowers down here. There's a saying, no lotus, no mud. So you guys have been through the depths of hell, right? A lotus flower grows through the mud into the light. So you guys have been through the darkness. You've been through, even if you look at these two cards here, these two cards are like nighttime cards, dark cards. You see like the sky is very dark here. But what it is that this person is wanting is a new beginning with you, a new start with this dove. There's a huge difference or a huge contrast between the skyline in this card and the skyline in this card. And so they're wanting to grow through the mud into the light with you. And so I feel you guys have gone through a lot of growing pains. Obviously, there's no communication, right? But they're wanting to communicate to you. They're wanting to express their love to you. They're wanting to come forth and have this new beginning with you. But here's the kicker. There was too much emphasis put on this person and not enough emphasis put on yourself. And so the universe needs you to balance this right now. The universe is asking you to come forth and love yourself as much as you have shown this other person that you've loved them through all of this pain, heartache, being the lotus, right? No mud, no lotus. Being that lotus, you had to go through darkness to get to this light. And when you got to the other side, you were still so focused on that other person, you forgot your own inner journey. And so the universe is asking you to love yourself first. The paradox is the more we pour into our own cup, which is why this Queen of Cups has this big ass cup facing this way. The more we pour into our own cup, the more it overflows into others. And so as you're in this hermit mode right now, go on a spiritual journey and fill your own cup. This is as much about self-love as it is about the love between soulmates, the love between lovers, that dance, that push and pull. The universe is asking you to, this is so gorgeous. I'm literally going through the bottom of the deck. The universe is asking you to tame your own inner beast, to fill your own cup, right? So that you can have this renewal. And look at this fucking renewal. You go literally from the Ace of Cups to the Ten of Cups. And all you got to do is fill your own cup. Fill your own cup. Fill your own cup. They want you to, too. Like, they want you to feel the same love that they feel from you. You've just neglected yourself. And it's time to retreat and work on that. Work on you, right? Work on yourself. Work on filling your own cup. Work on offering yourself this love. Once that comes in, and it will come in swiftly, right? It's just a recognition. I think you'll be good. So, what the hell is going on? The fact that you need to fill your own cup and nurture yourself. Look at that. Ha! What could be better? So, that's what I have for you if you chose reading number one. All right, universe, you know the deal. You know how we get down. You know what the hizzy is. I don't even know what the hizzy is. I don't even know why the hizzy I said that. So, reading number two, if you chose reading number two, there is no communication. What the hell is going on? Huh, universe? Can you tell us? There is no communication. What the hell is going on? There is no communication, universe. What the hell is going on? For those who have chosen reading number two. What the hell is going on, universe? We need answers. What the hell is going on? Those who chose reading number two. What the hell is going on? Got the Three of Cups. Those who chose reading number two. What the hell is going on? Got the Nine of Cups. A lot of emotion. And the Three of Swords. Let's get some Oracle cards. Those who chose reading number two, what the hell is going on? Separation is what the hell is going on. Universe, for those who chose reading number two, what the hell is going on? What the hell is going on? For those who chose reading number two, what the hell is going on, universe? What the hell is going on? Whoa. Pay attention to the red flags. All right, guys. This is what the hell is going on. There was some major heartbreak in this situation. Some major heartbreak. And the wish was to come clean and fill your own cup, to leave these Two of Cups down here and to really pour into your own cup. You see how these Two of Cups are overflowing? So in this situation, someone was focused more on the collective than they were on themselves. Similar to reading number one. So someone was more focused on the relationship and less focused on them. And now they are pouring that same love into themselves, because by doing that, they ignored a lot and they wore rose tinted glasses and they didn't pay attention to the red flags. And it led to this separation because there was no balance in this situation. There was no individuality in this situation. You guys are pretty much lost. Why is this Three of Swords here? Yeah, there was a decision made to cheat. Or third party situations can be a lot of different things. It can be cheating. I see this as excess, indulgence in abundant, excessive. Could be drinking, could be partying. Why is this Three of Swords here? It's as if a lot of sex. Ace of Wands is a phallic card. It's as if one person focused on themselves and one person focused on the relationship, right? And there was an imbalance. And now this person who was focused on themselves is wanting or wishing that they hadn't been, but still defensive. But you have turned the tables on them. You're like, oh, okay, I'm over this. Yeah, Three of Cups. You have the Three of Cups twice. So yeah, you're nurturing yourself now. It's exactly what I said. So the Two of Cups down here, there's no more focused on the relationship. There's only focus on yourself. You're sad. Don't get me wrong. You're sad about this. You're sad that it didn't work out, but you had to cut some shit out. You had to be blunt with this King of Pentacles here. So this is a couple right here, this King and Queen of Pentacles, but you had to be blunt and you had to walk away from them. I feel like this person could have gotten someone else pregnant. And that's what you found out. You have the Three of Cups here twice. There was definitely an indulgence in overabundance, in excess. But they could have gotten somebody pregnant. They're very defensive. And I feel like you're in a period right now where it's just time to renew yourself and heal yourself during this separation. They're watching you. But I think ultimately you're going to get, this will all come to an end, this sadness, right? Because you're filling your own cup. This will all come to an end and you're going to get an offering from someone else. You're going to move on. You're over this. Definitely over. You got the Death card and the World card. You're over this and you're going to move on into something better. I feel like this person got somebody else pregnant. Or they went back to like the mother of their child or the father of their child and had an affair with them. They had multiple affairs. They were just sticking their little thing in everybody. Here, you want some? Here, you want some? Here, you want some? Here, you want some? See all these people? That's what they were doing. Hey, little lady, you want some? You want some? You want some? They just gave it to everybody. Then they moved over here. You want some? You want some? You want some? It's just giving it to everybody. And Tower card just popped out. You're over it. You're over it. Became the Queen of Swords. You already know what she does. Judo chop. Boom. She judo chopped the shit out of everybody. Right? So he was just over here. You want some? You want? She was like, judo chop. Judo chop. Judo chop. Like, fuck this, man. Good for you. Rejected the offer. And again, you got the Nine of Cups here. Again, that's the second time. Nine of Cups is right here as well. You are going to be made a new offer of love. Someone new is coming in. You just got to finish healing. That's why there's no communication. You are going to decide once and for all to stay away from this person. They mean you no good whatsoever. That was two. Let's move on to number three. Let's move on to number three. Then we can see something. So the people who have chosen reading number three, universe, there's no communication. What the hell is going on? Oh, whoa. A shift is going on. The universe is stepping in. Got the Wheel of Fortune there. Universe is stepping in and shifting stuff. because you didn't want to shift it yourself. So the universe was like, oh, okay. Okay. Watch this. What's shifting, though? For the people who chose reading number three, what's shifting? What is shifting? What is shifting here? People who chose reading number three, what's shifting? The Hermit and the High Priestess keep trying to come out. What's shifting? Got the Eight of Cups, though. Walking away. Someone walked away or is walking towards something. I feel like someone was wearing a mask. Got the Seven of Wands. I feel like someone was wearing a mask. Like, going through some emotional things inwardly and not, but showing like this happy-go-lucky person outwardly. You have free yourself. It's time to take back control of your life. I almost feel like this person was going through like battling depression. Like went through something, cut some people off, thought that it was going to benefit them. You also have reconciliation. Thought that it was going to benefit them, but the lesson in all of this was humility. Like the Eight of Cups can be seen as a temporary walk away, right? It can also be seen as walking towards something. So it was like this person was creating these fights and things because of this mask that was going on within them. Not this mask that was going on within them. This fight that was going on within them that caused them to wear a mask. I feel like this person was battling depression and had a lot going on outside of the relationship and needed to free themselves from the happenings outside of the relationship, needed to go through a series of understanding, forgiveness, unlearning, letting go. This is why the universe shifted this, because a lot of times, I tell you guys this all the time, sometimes you can't do this growth inside of a relationship, but this person is like going into hermit mode. And the hermit mode is a very spiritual mode, right? It's a very spiritual space and place. But this person, I feel like, was coming to you in your dreams. I feel like you were having dreams about them or are still having dreams about them. That's because they're in hermit mode, right? That's because they're in this very spiritual zone. They're releasing. They're making space for this relationship. They had to free themselves from this cage that you see this unicorn in to make space for the relationship. Nothing else can fit in here with this unicorn. And so they had to make space for this relationship. And in doing so, I feel like they're going to come back and communicate the truth to you. Communicate what was really going on and what their battles were. I see that they truly love you. You have the Six of Cups here and you have the King of Cups here. So this is a soulmate relationship, but there was just a lot of chaos and confusion that was in it because of everything that was going on outside of the relationship for this person. Why is the Wheel of Fortune here? Yeah. The universe stepped in so they could shift out of this mental chaos. They just weren't clear. It was just a lot going on outside of them. Eight of Cups, why is it here? Their wish was to make space. They were undecided about how they could release all of this and still make you happy. Could have been drinking a lot too. Could have been trying to control the situation, but they were wearing a mask. They were sad on the inside. Look at this. Sad on the inside, mental prison on the inside. Love you a lot. Here's the King of Cups again. So that's the second time we see the King of Cups. They adore you. But they needed to regain their sense of self. They needed to regain their own confidence. And they are watching you right now. They want a renewal with you. This is what they're manifesting, is some type of renewal with you. But they didn't want to bring this toxicity into this relationship. So they had to do it alone. They had to do it alone. They didn't have a choice. That's why the universe stepped in. If they would have, there would be no room. If they would have done this in the relationship, there would have been no room for this reconciliation here. Had they freed themselves in this relationship, there would not be space for you. So, yeah, that's what I have for you. That's what the hell is going on. They're healing, they're forgiving, and they're learning. And you just need to remain optimistic and know that this wait is worth it. Because when they come back, they will come back stronger. Here this is again. This popped out again. Three of Pentacles. They want to build something with you. Quite possibly this relationship will move on into a marriage. But they needed to cut some things out. They had to cut some things out of their life. And they really needed time for themselves. And that's the thing about relationships that we don't talk enough about. When you see that someone needs time for themselves, that doesn't mean that they don't love you, don't want to be with you. None of those things. That just means something is happening within them that they can't make sense of. And they can damage you if you stick around by trying to make sense of it through you, because no one can help them with this. And a lot of times when we're in love with people, we want to help or take their pain away. And in taking their pain away, we remove the lesson from them that has to circle back around in another form through another person, because that lesson is destined for them. And so a lot of times when we think that we're saving someone, we're actually hurting them or setting them back by trying to save them. So we just have to step back and allow. And that's what this shift is about. Stepping back and just allowing. So that's what I have for you guys. I hope you all enjoyed it. Hit the like button. Thanks. Bye.